I know what it's like to just fall into a beauty and skincare rut. And trust me, it happens to beauty YouTubers and beauty bloggers as well, where it just feels like one little slip starts to snowball. And one morning I'll just wake up, I look in my mirror and I think to myself, I don't even know who this person is anymore. If that sounds like you, I have 5 very simple and effective changes that you can make starting today, and you're going to quickly get back on track to just feeling like the most beautiful version of yourself. Hi, I'm Lauren O'Connell, and I am going to help you get out of that rut. The number one thing you need to do, and I'm guessing this is something you're probably not doing right now. This is something I do every single day, and you must do it every day as well. That is to change your pillowcase. Think about it. When you're sleeping at night on your pillowcase, you could have oil from your hair. If you didn't wash your hair before you went to sleep, you're going to have whatever is stuck to your hair throughout the day on your pillowcase, hair products on your pillowcase. You're going to have skincare. If you sweat at night, you're going to have sweat on that pillowcase. You get the point. So why would you put your beautiful face, your skin, the skin that you're spending so much money on with products and time to take care of, why would you put that on a surface that's not clean for 8 hours? You wouldn't. And I'm guessing you probably don't wear the same pair of underwear every day, and I hope you don't, but whatever, that's your business. But you should absolutely change your pillowcase every single night. You will notice an increase already into your skin's health and just overall vitality when you change that pillowcase, especially if you are prone to blemishes. Think about it. If you constantly have blemishes, maybe your pillowcase is part of the culprit. Now, in terms of pillowcase materials, what I really like to use is silk. And I like silk because I feel that it's very gentle on my skin. My skin is prone to fine lines and wrinkles. I'm 37 years old, and I just want to put materials on my skin that are very soft and aren't going to be rough and rough up my skin. I also like cotton, and I use pillowcases that have a very high count. How do you say that? I use pillowcases that have a very high thread count. There we go. So you don't have to spend a lot of money on these. Look online, shop around, find a good deal. And if you do laundry once a week, then figure you need to buy yourself 7 pillowcases. It is an expense, but it's going to really, really pay off. Tip number 2 also involves the bed. And what I do, and this is something else I do every single night, is I always keep a moisturizer on my bedside table. That's because at least once a night I wake up, usually to go to the bathroom, and every single time I wake up, I replenish my skin with moisturizer. My skin is extremely dry, so it does need that hydration throughout the night, and I notice a massive difference on my skin the next morning if I have used a moisturizer in the middle of the night. If you have normal skin, combination, or oily skin, and you just want to do something, why not just use a mist on your skin if you wake up, just to give your skin some extra nutrients, antioxidants, and to give it a boost during the night. I do really love this Biossance Squalane Micronutrient Fine Mist. The ingredients in this product are fantastic. I haven't reviewed this on my channel yet, but I use this product on my face all the time. And if I didn't need a heavy moisturizer during the night, I would use this just to give my skin that boost. The 2 products I keep at my bedside table are the Volition Celery Green Cream, as well as the Ole Henriksen Sea Rush Brightening Gel Cream. This is a great one if you have normal skin. Number 3 is not just what you're putting on your skin, but what you're putting in your body. If you're drinking soda, you need to stop. You just have to stop drinking soda. It's not good for you, and it's horrible for your skin. That includes diet sodas. If you drink juices that are full of sugars, ditch those as well. What I do every morning is I have a cappuccino and I use oat milk in my cappuccino as opposed to cow milk. And then for the rest of the day, I guzzle water. People constantly say to me, oh, your skin is so nice. What products are you using? And that's part of my skincare routine. But the other part is that I am an incredibly hydrated woman, and the water that I drink really does keep my skin looking so youthful and so fresh. I really believe that water is the fountain of youth. Now, if you hate drinking water, here are two things you can do to make it a little bit more tolerable. Number one, I can drink anything fast if it comes with a straw. That doesn't always work out well for me if I'm out with my girlfriends on a girls' night and you get the drift. Maybe I'm drinking something a little too fast. But in general, I find that when I have anything with a straw, it just is a lot easier and quicker to drink. Also, I love to infuse water with different fruits, vegetables, and herbs. This water has cucumber, lemon, and mint in it. It makes me feel like I'm at a spa. It makes me feel like I'm doing something a little bit fancy. And also the cucumber is great for hydrating the skin. And the lemon is a detox. So this is going to help to remove impurities within your system and to just give you glowing, hydrated skin. This is full of vitamins and antioxidants. There are so many different water recipes. You can just easily go on Pinterest, do a quick search, and so many different combinations will come up. And a lot of them will also explain the skin benefits for drinking these types of waters. If you are very used to drinking juices and sodas and that's hard for you to give up, infusing your water with these different elements will help to make that transition a little bit more tolerable. Tip number four has two different parts. Number one, you should absolutely start using a vitamin C serum if you haven't already. Vitamin C is going to make your skin look incredibly bright. It's going to even out your complexion. And if you have any type of hyperpigmentation, sunspots, age spots, acne spots, anything, it's going to help to minimize them, to make them fade. I love vitamin C, and I believe that everyone over the age of 30 should use a vitamin C serum in their skincare routine. The two that I recommend are the Mad Hippie Vitamin C Serum, as well as the Biossance Squalane and Vitamin C Rose Oil. This works very well for any type of skin. This one, the Biossance, is incredible for anyone with dry and sensitive skin. If you're not using a vitamin C serum right now, you can take that first step towards more beautiful skin and getting out of that rut by just going online and purchasing one. If you look on the Biossance website, I do notice that from time to time, they do have different discount codes, coupon codes. So shop around, look online, find a good deal, and just buy one and start using it. I do also want to mention that if you use a retinol, you can use both of these vitamin C's at the same time. And that's because these are vitamin C derivatives and they don't inactivate the retinol or vice versa. They work very nicely together. The second component of number four is you must, if you're not doing it right now, please do it today. Wear sunscreen. It doesn't matter if you're on lockdown, if you can't leave your home, you still have windows and those sun rays are going to come through and damage your skin. I wear sunscreen 365 days a year, all seasons, and if it's raining, I still wear sunscreen. You should too. The sunscreen I like to use on my face is this Nimu Sun C SPF 40. This works really well underneath makeup. And it is a broad spectrum sunscreen, so your skin is going to be protected from both the UVA and UVB rays. This also does come in an SPF 50. They just released one. So when I run out of this product, I will switch to the 50. The sunscreen that I put over my entire body, and if I'm wearing jeans, if I am it doesn't matter what I'm wearing, I'll wear this anyways. And it is the Sun Balm. It's a broad spectrum sunscreen, once again, very important, but it also is just packed with vitamin E, and it makes my skin just look so smooth. It feels so soft, and I mix this with a little bit of moisturizer, but honestly, I could use this one on its own. I will say I did try the SPF 70, and for me, the texture was just off, but the 50 is amazing. I also wanna point out that if you are already using a sunscreen all over your body, just take a look at the ingredients. Make sure it does not have the ingredient called retinol palmitate, because that's actually a very weak form of retinol. And that's something you definitely do not want to put on your skin during the day with exposure to the sun, because it's actually going to have the reverse effect and it's going to age your skin. So check your sunscreen, make sure it doesn't have retinol palmitate. If you're confused about it, I recommend just picking up the Sun Balm, and you can find these all over Amazon, the internet, everywhere for cheap. The fifth thing that I highly recommend you do, and this is something you should absolutely do, is to implement a morning and nighttime skincare routine into your life that you will stick to with products that are good for your skin. Head on over to my playlist on Lauren's Perfect Skin Recipe. In this playlist, I share with you my morning skincare routine, my nighttime, and my under eye routine. I share the products that I use, the order I use them in, why I use them, what the ingredients are, and what they do for my skin. I also include every single tip and trick that I have. After that, head on over to my playlist on products that turn back the clock. These are products I've used on my skin, and they are great, and I share my real results with you. Keep in mind, I do not have any filters. Well, no filters on this video. I meant to say I don't have any fillers on my face, and I do not have any Botox either. So head on over there, and don't forget to say hi.